So today I'm going to show you guys how to turn this old janky business card into a new digital business card.
She's an icon, she's a legend, and she is the moment. Now come on now.
What's up, icons? It's the iconic fashion figure back with a new video. And you guys, I've discovered these NFC tags. Let me take some out of this bag so you can see. But they're NFC tags that a lot of people use for like home automation, or the way that most people may know it is with the tap to pay on our phones that a lot of us are using right now. So that same tap to pay feature that we're all using as part of our day-to-day life now can also be used for your business. And not just for payment, but for so many other ways when it comes to your business. So today's video, I'm gonna show you guys how I use these NFC tags for my business, whether it's the digital business card, if it's on my hang tags, and so many other ways. So keep on watching. So for the NFC tags that I have, I bought these on Amazon. They're really easy to get, really easy to program. I can't believe I didn't discover these sooner. But basically, these NFC tags are more like the traditional style business card, which I want to use to create my digital business card. These come in a pack of 20 of them. I think I paid around like $17, so less than a dollar per card to create a business card. And these ones are printable. So that's why I paid a little more, because you can actually get them cheaper if you just get the standard disc versus paying for the printable version. But you can print on these on an inkjet printer. The only thing is, it specifically says on there, which I did not read, that you have to either have a Canon or an Epson printer. I don't have either one, but I'm definitely going to invest in it because these are going to become very useful. Plus, I need a new printer anyway. But these are printable. I don't know if you guys can kind of see that little chip in there, but that's what you use for the what we know as tap to pay, but basically tap to do anything you really want it to do. So that's that one. And then you have the little disc ones, which I'm going to show you guys how I put these inside of my hang tags and what you can do with them. Now, they do have sticker ones that actually have an adhesive on there, which is what I thought I was buying. Again, I wasn't reading what I was buying. I was just adding to cart and checking out. So these ones don't have the adhesive on it, but you can get the ones that have the adhesive and they just stick to everything. These ones I paid, I think, like $10 for a pack of 30 pieces. So like 30 cents per disc. This one is really good for your money. I think the adhesive ones are actually even cheaper because they're literally like a sticker. But I'll link both of these that I purchased in the description box below, and I'll also link the adhesive ones in case you guys want those, because once you see what I'm about to do with them, you'll probably want the adhesive ones. So let me get right into what I'm doing with these. So I'm going to start out by showing you guys how I program the NFC tags, because it's really easy. It literally only takes like 2 seconds to do it. I use an app called NFC Tools. I do have some that I already programmed, so really quickly I'm going to show you guys how it works. If you guys don't understand what I mean with tap to pay, I'm going to show you guys how it works, and then I'll show you how to program it. So on your phone, all you literally do is hold your phone near the disc. You see where it says NFC tag, open an Instagram. It takes me right to my business's Instagram. These I already programmed to link right to my business Instagram. You can have it linked to anything that has a link. So this one's already programmed just because I wanted to test it out. But let me show you guys how to actually program them. So I'll do a whole new one. So to program our first tag, we'll go to write. On here, you'll see the options that say add a record, more options, and write. The first thing you'll want to do is go to add a record, since there's no records listed on there yet. On here, you can see there's a bunch of different options as far as the different records you can add to these tags. Me personally, I pretty much just use URL or social networks, because they literally have every social network you can think of. And all you have to do is include your handle and write it to the tag, and it'll link to your social. But since I already have one with my social, I'm gonna do URL, and I'm gonna point it to my website. And then click OK once you have it in there. So now we see there's a URL at the bottom, and all you have to do is click write, and it tells you to approach a NFC tag. So I'm just gonna tap it on there, and we have our check mark. So now that means that's saved on there. To confirm it, I can just go into my phone and then test it out. And at the top, it says website NFC tag, and it takes me directly to my website. So you can put those on any website you can think of, but since this one has my website on it, I'm gonna set it to the side. This one I want to link to a digital business card. But before I actually program it to the digital business card, I want to show you guys how to actually create the digital business card online, because of course we need a link to connect to this card. So let me skip to that and then we'll come back and program this card.
Right now I am in Canva getting ready to create my digital business card. Now you don't have to do this in Canva. I just choose to use Canva because, one, I love Canva and I use it for everything. Two, because I have complete design control of this. You can also use websites like Linktree, Bitly, anywhere you can create, you know, like your profile and have a link to it. A lot of people already have Linktree because you use it on your social media. So if you already have that, you can bypass this entire step and skip ahead to link it to the actual digital business card where I show you how to program it. But if you actually want to do the creative side and create your own digital business card, this is how I do it in Canva. So I start with a template of 2 inches by 3.5. You can actually create it as the full screen size on a phone. I do 2 by 3.5 because that's usually the standard business card. So if ever I wanted to actually print this, then I could actually print it and it's in the right specs. But otherwise, you can do it on a bigger scale if you would like. So 2 inches by 3.5, and I'm just gonna start creating my design. Now, again, I said you have full creative control of this, so you can do what you want to do, but I'm just gonna throw something together to show you guys what I'm doing. So these are the social icons I went with. I'm gonna do some updates to them, but for now, just so you can see, all of the social media icons are available on Canva. And then I'm gonna add all my different businesses on here. So now that my business names, the websites, and email is on there, I'm gonna go through and play with this and make some edits to make this look somewhat decent. And then I'll show you guys my final results once I get there. So I'm still working on the whole layout and the aesthetic of my digital business card. This is where I am so far. But before I continue on with editing and playing around with all of this, I just wanted to show you guys how you would link all of these different links to a website. So let's say for Instagram. On Canva, it allows you to actually link it to your Instagram. So with this little link at the top right, just type in your Instagram handle, or you have to put the full link. And if you don't know your Instagram link, it's basically instagram.com/ and then whatever your Instagram handle is. And you can do it with text as well. So it doesn't have to just be the images with the text too. I can go to that same thing and then just type in my website. Now with the text, it puts the line under there. There has to be a way, here we go, we can take the line out, but there's still a link. So it's still a link because that box is gray, but I don't have that line underneath it because I don't want it there. Okay, so now all my social media is linked. I have all of these two websites here are linked. I'm gonna keep playing around with this entire design, but I don't want to bore you guys. Oh wait, this is one thing I do want to fix though, because that is so ugly. Okay, so I'm just gonna stop here. This is not my final result. I want to do more to this. I feel like this is just a base and I have to do so much more with this. So I'm gonna save this just so I can show you guys how to create the link, because you can create it directly in Canva, and then I'll go in on how to program it to one of your NFC cards, so that way you can use a digital business card. And really quickly, for those of you, because I didn't tell you how I changed these social media icons to pink, if you click on it, you can edit the image, and then there's a bunch of different options of ways you can edit them. So I can add all these different features and effects, and then dual tone was the color. So you have all the different colors there that you can change those. So just in case you wanted to change the colors of your social media icons, you can. But yeah, this gives you an idea of the things you can do in Canva to create a digital business card. So now to get the link so we can go ahead and program this, we'll go to these three dots in the top right corner and then share link. And then you can just copy this link. We're going to need that link for when we go program the business card.
So now we're back with NFC Tools because we just created our digital business card. Hopefully you guys came up with a template that you guys like. If you want to see a few different templates that you can use for your digital business card, I'll throw a few ideas on the screen so you guys can get your creative minds going to create it. But once that's created, now we're going to go in to write the digital business card so that it works with the actual card that you would use to tag. So we'll go to write just like we did before. Let me delete this one out of here because that I don't need on this card. So we're going to add a record URL, that link we created. We're going to paste that in here. I already have it copied, and then click OK. And then we're going to write, and then just like before, tap it till you get the check mark, and that one's done. Like I told you guys before, these are printable, but I don't have the right printer to print on it. I am going to create a sticker that I'm put on there. I do have stickers like the ones that I have for my business that I can use, but I have a different sticker that I also created in Canva that I'm just going to print out and stick on here. So as you can see, I went ahead and I taped on or stuck on my covers that I want to put on here since I don't have the right printer to print exactly to this. All I did was in Canva created another document where it was the 3.5 by 2, or is it 2 by 3.5 now because this is the opposite direction, and just stuck them on here because they're like stickers. This artwork I could have definitely made bigger on this one. This just wasn't originally created for this. I just printed off a document I already had. I have the NFC tag that has my artwork on it. I can literally show this to people and tell them, yeah, you know, go follow me, go check out my website, and all they have to do is tap and they'll get to my digital business card, which has my websites on there and my social media. Because we created those links on the digital business card, this is what people will see when they tap it. And then I can just touch Instagram and it takes me directly to my Instagram. You can go to the website as well. And then you also have the other social medias on there and it takes you to my TikTok. And then same thing with the Nouveau Rich one. It can have my contact information, so company email, company phone number, address, website, all of that. And all they have to do is tap and get to that information as well. I can do so many of these different cards, especially since I have multiple businesses. You can do these if you're like at a show and you want to offer a promo. They can just tap to receive the promo, sign up for your newsletter. You can do it for service, all of that stuff. But now I'm back to the little tag. So we had the little circle tag that I originally directed right to my website. And I wanted to show you guys how I would use these with my hang tag. So these are the garment hang tags that will go on clothing. Now I have a few different options. I just took some of my accessory hang tags since I had some readily available. This is the one for like earrings. Technically, I can just stick that to the back and all people have to do is tap to. This one's for necklaces and it closes. I can put it on the inside and people can tap that one. But what I'm going to do is on the hang tag. So the reason I want to put it inside of the hang tag, because let's say you ship an item to a customer and it has the hang tag on it. They're happy with their item and they want to buy more from you. They can easily take their phone, tap the tag, it'll take you to the website, and you can literally redirect them to, let's say, items that may match with the item they just purchased, or items that are similar to what they purchased that they may also like. So that way you can receive another order from them. Or for example, this tag is for accessories. So they purchase a pair of earrings from me, they can tap the tag and see some outfits that may work really well with the accessories that they just bought. Or it can go to a promo. So because you just ordered from me today, here's an additional 15% off of your next order. And all they have to do is tap the tag to receive the promotional offer. Like, there's so many ways I can think of to do with this. So as soon as I saw these NFC tags, I just knew I had to have them because I can do so much with this. And since the world is going digital, we have to adapt to what the world is doing right now. So I'm gonna stop talking about this because I can go on with different opportunities, and I'm gonna go ahead and put this together and show you guys how this works. So of course, when I go to do my crafts for you guys, I can never seem to find glue. So all I did was put two hang tags together, and for professionally, I would have glued them together. But for video sake, just so I can show you guys, it is taped together, but it's two of my hang tags put together with the NFC tag glued in on the inside. And of course, the hang tag string, because it would be attached to a garment or any type of item or anything like that. And literally, once your customers receive this, I would put on here, you know, tap for more or something like that, some type of directions to go with it, so people know to actually tap it. And then of course, once they have their phone, they tap it, and like you guys saw at the beginning of this video, I linked this tag to my website. So now they will receive this, it would take them to the website, or you can do a specific page, like a promo page with the offering. It could be a page of recommended items that they should check out, a bunch of different things that you can create with this. They can write a review for the item that they just purchased. You can also do like thank you cards. A lot of people insert thank you cards with their order, so you can also do that and put one of the NFC tags on there, so that way your customers again could revisit your website, shop with you again, write a review for you, follow you on social media, whatever it is you want to do. The opportunities are endless when it comes to these NFC tags in your business. Get creative with it, find ways to bring people back to your business. But that's pretty much it for this video. I just wanted to give you a couple ideas of what you can do with these NFC tags. Of course, if I come up with more ideas, I'll most likely either put it on social media, like on my Instagram or TikTok or something like that. But if I come up with something really good that requires a full YouTube video, I'm sure you guys will be seeing it again. Thank you for watching.